If Ultima is your first Smash game, then you might not really understand the point of Mii Fighters, or even Miis in general. If you didn't know, Miis are Nintendo's player avatar characters which originated on the Wii. There were a great deal of customization options to create your big-headed, digital look-alike. Mii creation was a bit more low-key on the Wii U, but Smash 4 on the Wii U introduced a new way to use it, Mii Fighters. The announcement was actually pretty exciting, as this was the first time players could customize a Smash character in any way, well accompanied by the custom moves that applied to almost any character in the game. In Smash 4, Mii Fighters could be created from any existing Mii character on your console, with the body size of the Mii actually contributing to the attributes of the Mii Fighter. From there, you could choose from one of the three fighter types: Brawler, Gunner, and Sword Fighter. This is the same in Smash Ultimate, as in the next step wherein you can choose between three different special move options for each direction. The body size factors were actually banned in Smash 4 tournaments, as a small-bodied Mii Brawler possessed incredible movement and a ridiculous special move option, which was usually banned as well. In Smash Ultimate, the Mii's body sizes are standardized, and there's much more emphasis on the outfits that your Mii can wear. Mii creation still exists on the Switch, but it's still an unpronounced feature that most Switch owners forget even exists. Competitively, the Miis are scarcely seen, even with the attention-grabbing costumes like Sans or Cuphead, but this doesn't necessarily make them bad characters. They're actually quite capable, perhaps just lacking representation due to the vast selection of more authentic characters in Smash Ultimate. But we need to know which Mii Fighter is actually the best. Before we find out, make sure to check out ProGuides.com for more Smash content and resources. We've got guides for every single Mii Fighter if you want to learn even more about them. You can also take advantage of our Play with Pros feature to get instant access to top coaches and learn from the best of our exclusive pro courses. Anyway, to determine which Mii Fighter is most viable, let's start by looking deep into each fighter's attributes. First is the Mii Brawler. The Brawler's normal moveset is based on characters like Mario and Captain Falcon. He has multiple combo starters, linking moves out of down tilt, up tilt, and down throw, up air, and neutral air. As for movement, Brawler is pretty quick on the ground, and in the air, he has a quick fall speed as well. His startup frame data is above average, with a frame 3 nair and a frame 2 jab just like Mario, but his attacks have a bit of cooldown, limiting him to 2 or 3 hit combos in most situations. His up air is a flip kick like many other characters, so it's pretty good for juggling. His dash attack is fast and lunges far to whip punish and trap landings. And his up smash is the same frame as Fox's and can sometimes be comboed out of nair. Brawler doesn't have the biggest hitboxes, unfortunately, and his attacks are pretty weak in general, making it hard to close out stocks. Now for Brawler's special moves. For his neutral special, the shot put is both the first option and the most commonly chosen for Brawler players. This move throws out a heavy iron ball that has decent knockback. Since they plummet downwards, these can be great for edgeguarding. Even if it doesn't KO, your opponent will certainly not want to catch one of these, if you know what I'm saying, when they're off stage. The second neutral option is Flashing Mach Punch. This attack launches a flurry of punches, dealing a lot of damage and decent knockback. It's pretty slow and has lots of end lag, so few players opt for this move. The last neutral special is Exploding Sidekick. This is Mii Brawler's equivalent of Falcon Punch. It's likewise very slow and very strong, but usually not worth the risk. Shot put is almost always agreed to be Brawler's best neutral special, and it's a decent projectile that helps compensate for his lack of range. Next for side specials, we have Onslaught. This is basically the Flashing Mach Punch with a lunge at the start. It's also slow and has lots of end lag, with an interesting mechanic that makes it stronger when Brawler has more damage. I actually did not know that. Oh wow! It's pretty strong even without the damage boost, so it's decent as a high-risk, high-reward option. The second side special is Burning Dropkick. This is somewhat similar to Peach's Bomber, as it lunges you forward, letting you bounce off of your opponent if the move connects. You can also bounce off of walls, and it doesn't pull you in freefall, so this can be used as a recovery option as well. The last side special is Suplex. This move is a command grab, similar to Ganon's Flame Choke. Although it won't put you in a tech chase or KO, you can achieve a suicide KO with this move, just like Ganon's. The first of Brawler's up specials is Soaring Axe Kick. This move launches Brawler pretty far straight up, which makes for a decent recovery, and can also drop back down to spike the opponent or launch them away as it lands. Soaring Axe Kick can be used as an out of shield option as well, and is typically the most common up B used by many Brawler players. Brawler's second up special is Helicopter Kick. In Smash 4, this move was absurdly broken, kind of, taking stocks at extremely low percents near the blast zone. While it can still be used as a combo finisher and for KOs at high percents, this move is significantly worse than it was in Smash 4, and still a poor recovery move vertically. The last upbeat is Thrust Uppercut. This one is a bit similar to Mario's, rising up with multi-hits that end with a punch. At frame 3, this is Brawler's fastest out-of-shield option, and it's not a bad recovery either. Finally, we have Brawler's down specials. The first is Head-On Assault. The name is quite accurate, as Brawler literally drops down with his head and launches opponents away. The second down special is Feint Jump. This move is basically a worse version of Zero Suit's Flip Jump. Brawler jumps in one direction and can achieve a kick either forward or back. Feint Jump is a good option in disadvantage and aids in recovery, although the kick is very laggy to land with. Lastly, for me, Brawler's specials is his third down special, Counter Throw. This move functions like most counters, although it launches opponents behind him with a grab. It has limits to what kind of attacks it can activate as well. Mii Sword Fighter takes some inspiration from Link, but his moveset and playstyle are actually pretty unique. Sword Fighter has lots of combos out of down throw and down tilt, and decent range in general thanks to his sword. His back air is excellent for spacing, his up air is great for juggling, and he can edgeguard with his forward and down air. Mii Sword Fighter's specials are less polarizing than Brawler's, with some obvious best choices that define his meta. His first neutral special is Gale Strike. Yes, the infamous tornado move that you can't escape on quick play. It's so annoying! This rather large projectile travels a good distance and launches opponents straight upwards, allowing Sword Fighter to combo into an aerial, even his third up B for an early kill confirmed. Gale Strike is undoubtedly Sword Fighter's best neutral special, but his second best option is Shuriken of Light. This is a decent projectile that he can use to control space, but it's not no tornado, hey! His third special is another one of those flurry moves that they love giving to the Miis. This one can be charged and it's pretty strong, but it's no tornado, hey, you already know. Sword Fighter's first side special is Airborne Assault. Sword Fighter lunges very far and bounces off of any enemy he collides with. The travel range on this move makes it a horizontal recovery option. His second side special is Gale Stab. This is kind of like a worse version of Ike's Quick Draw. It travels pretty far when charged, but sometimes has issues grabbing the ledge. The third side special is Chakram. This interesting projectile can be aimed in different directions and has different uses with smash and tilt inputs. It can cover a lot of space or even start combos, making this a popular special that aids in Sword Fighter's zoning ability. Sword Fighter's first up special, Stone Scabbard, is pretty similar to Brawler's Axe Kick. He dives into the air and drops down with an attack that spikes. This is a decent vertical recovery too. Skyward Slash Dash is Sword Fighter's most versatile recovery move, as it could be aimed in many directions. This move can even be used on stage to approach opponents, although it isn't very safe. His last up B is Hero Spin, blatantly inspired by Link's spin attack. This move offers average recovery, but its great knockback makes it an amazing follow-up to his Gale Strike. Yes, the tornado. Hey, so this is a common pick. Sword Fighter's first down special is Blade Counter. This one's pretty self-explanatory if you've played almost any Fire Emblem character. The second is Reversal Slash, which functions almost exactly like Mario's cape, both reversing opponents and reflecting projectiles. Lastly, his Power Thrust is similar to Falcon Kick. It could be a good surprise burst option, but it's very laggy and thus unsafe. The Mii Gunner probably has the most representation online thanks to the unique costumes made for it. Gunner isn't much of a combo character, but she excels in zoning even without her specials. Her forward air is a long-range projectile that pushes her back, so she can use it as a movement option. Her up air, forward tilt, and forward smash all have large disjoints as well. Gunner's special moves grant her many projectiles to aid with zoning and camping. Her first neutral special is Charge Blast. This move is extremely similar to Samus and Dark Samus. Charge Shot, charging a strong ball of energy, which can be B-reversed and jump canceled as a movement option. Neutral special 2 is Laser Blaze. This is very similar to Falco's laser, but also pretty laggy, so few gunners use this. Neutral special 3 is called Grenade Launch. As the name suggests, this fires a grenade, which Gunner can then chase behind before it explodes. This can start combos, aid in approaches, and help cover ledge options. Next, Gunner's side special is Flame Pillar. This is very similar to Robin's Arc Fire, although arguably better because it doesn't expire after many uses. This move is an amazing ledge trap and can even hit the characters as they hang. Side B2 is a Stealth Burst. This move can catch people by surprise as it fires a cloaked projectile in a straight line that explodes upon releasing the B button. Its limited vertical range makes this more ineffective against players who are familiar with it, however. Her third side special is Gunner Missile, which is pretty much exactly the same as Samus Missile. You can opt for a tilt or smash input to change the missile variety, and this move is great for more defensive gameplay forcing approaches. Gunner's up specials are all pretty similar, using the arm cannon to propel her upwards. The first option, Lunar Launch, travels a moderate distance with a weak hit at the start. The second, Cannon Jump, travels very little distance but has a devastating spike hitbox, as well as a kick hitbox. Gunner's third up special is Arm Rocket, which travels the greatest distance and has more angular flexibility, but lacks a hitbox. Gunner's first down special is Echo Reflector, which is similar to Fox's Reflector. It reflects projectiles and has a hitbox as it activates. The second is Bomb Drop. This move drops a small bomb in front of Gunner that can be manually detonated by throwing out another one. These bombs are excellent tools for edgeguarding and ledge trapping, especially against big bodies. The bombs, however, can be hit back by opponents, so be careful. And finally, Gunner's third down special is Absorbing Vortex. This one is similar to Ness's PSI Magnet, and its activation hitbox can hit opponents below the ledge as well. So looking at the Miis, they each function accurately to their archetypes. Brawler is an up-close fighter with a decent combo game. Swordfighter is a master of disjoints, mid-range gameplay. And Gunner is the best at zoning and camping with projectiles. Overall, we think Mii Gunner is the best Mii. Well, they think it. I think it's Brawler. But that's another story. Her oppressive projectile game makes her difficult to deal with in general, but against slow or large characters, she's actually a great counterpick character. When it comes to outright keep away and long distance zoning, Mii Gunner is legitimately one of the best in the game. Mii Swordfighter is very solid as well, especially with the combos he gets from Gale Strike, but there are just so many better sword characters in Smash Ultimate. That being said, Swordfighter is the only Mii to make a PGRU appearance, with Sue using them as a secondary in the first spring season. While Mii Brawler fits his archetype, he does so in such a lackluster way. His combos don't come close to the characters like Mario, his edgeguarding and advantage state are much tamer than Captain Falcon's, and his pressure and KO power are nothing like Fox's, so there really isn't any reason to play Mii Brawler over pretty much any other Brawl character in the game, unless you are Keitaro. Like many other Smash 4 heavy hitters fall into mid-tier Grace and Ultimate, Brawler essentially got the same treatment as they used to be the strongest Mii in Smash 4. Who do you think is the best Mii? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to keep up with more from ProGuides.